Hello world, I'm a Carp. Welcome back to Cultist Simulator with the Ghoul DLC second try. At this moment, we are painting a mood piece. We are reading some sentimental literature to get some glimmers and we can combine our lores here. We are not dreaming. Why aren't we dreaming? We had the frangiclave. Let's just dream about the pickaxe door with the frangiclave. A tuning fork hum animates the key in my hand. The pickaxe door groans in response. Already a sensuous shiver ripples its surface. It aches for fracture, and when finds its satisfaction, I will enter. We are repairing a cracked wielding mirror, which we really don't need to do anymore, that we have the frangiclave. We have some evidence here, which is kind of unfortunate. Season of ambitions coming. We have sent our people at the star shattered bane, and there is a dormant creeping breath curse over here, which is... very unfortunate, but what can we do about that? Not really much. Okay, we send more people over here. Wonder what it was that we required. Hot or winter? Well, we have winter here. Forge or grail? Okay, winter and forge. And lantern or knock. Right, why's all of this stuff here, like, completely in disarray? Just stay where you should be. Right, lantern, hope, go there. Okay, there's a glimmering, so let's combine these forbidden epics next. And there's a painting done. Ooh, some fascination. That's not nice. But at least there's a season of fascination coming. Can we get rid of that somehow? Also, this writhing call should be here where the other writhing call is. No, we don't have any fleeting reminiscences over here. Well, we could take someone in the cult to get rid of that that way. Let's paint. Are we... Oh, we're pretty damn stale. No, what is... How much is our staleness? 5. That's pretty stale. Do we even get any money if we just paint with Mystique? We're pretty low on money. Let's paint a glimmering. And we'll use our last bronze spin tray to fix the mirror, which we can then sell if we want to. Oh, where's our graveyard mouth at? Ooh, 2. So it's gonna go to 3. Let's hope that we can find something to eat from here. Unresolved ambiguity. No, we'll go to the museum, get another perfect frost. What in the world? Okay. Okay, now I'm pretty sure where the, this must have been a start of a new draw, because the last thing we got from there was a perfect frost as well. But hey, at least now we can just keep dreaming about the pickaxe door, which is fantastic. Okay, the dry road. You are strong in forge, but not strong enough. Okay, so we're gonna have to send Valciana from here after she's finished fixing the mirror, which is now. So Valciana, you go over here, and you guys should be okay there. Then Isabeth. Oh come on, autosave. Isabeth, get rid of that tentative evidence, please. What's coming up next? Season of Dread. I don't care about that. Okay, our graveyard mouth is a 3. That's pretty worrisome. Like, that's the halfway point, so we'd rather... Oh, I forgot to check if we actually got any money. Let's paint some more and see if we get any money. Mystique. And let's paint the perfect frost. What do you want? You want the library. Here's the library. This creeping breath curse is still dormant. Kind of scares me. Okay, pickaxe door. We led to the worm museum. Get a dread. Right, well, next time there most definitely should be a vagabond's map waiting for us over there. But hey, we can dream that dread away with that fascination. So, that's fine. Okay, you still need lantern people there, right? Yeah, sleep. Off you go. Okay, we're at 25 here. Huh. Absolutely no money for this. So, ooh, Isabeth got rid of the evidence. Very, very nice. So, we really need to paint with some passion to get rid of that thing. What thing? Ah, staleness. Yeah, staleness is the thing. Okay, talk. Talk to people. Do we want to get rid of the perfect frost? Probably. So let's just take Tristan into cult. Or, I mean, let's upgrade him into a disciple. You guys are gonna need some more funds there as well. Ooh, we're running really low on funds. Let's sell the Scaptodon fangs as soon as these guys get from here. So we're gonna have a good amount of funds. We'll put the glimmering over here. I get so pissed off when this push the verbs I have put here in a nice row, and then these other verbs come. Oh, there goes my health. And push them around. The creeping breath curse begins with a cough that loiters in one throat like a debt collector. Okay, this is gonna give us it's gonna give us probably a decrepitude. Like, it's just not gonna eat that. Or is it just gonna eat it? Like, it just ate my reason, the previous curse. I'm thinking, what are we gonna require to do the, if it gives us a decrepitude, what are we gonna require for the Forge's redemption? So that it's really good. We probably don't have any good rights for that, to be perfectly honest. Ah. We'll head to the Peacock's door. Okay, now we got at least one fund for that. And let's paint with just one passion next. Still paint the glimmering, sure. Could sell the wildering mirror as well though. It's got a pretty good value. And we don't need it for anything anymore. Okay, Tristan is now a disciple as well. We'll put him here. And what's coming up next? Season of Sickness. We do have a vitality here, so let's talk to Sulakana about the vitality. Keep it around. I know there's a Vagabond's map here, so I gotta go take it. What? Okay, now I am honestly confused. Did I? No, I didn't take. What? Okay, woo. Still head back there. I got a perfect. No. No. What? Did I already get the Vagabond's map from there? I probably did and I forgot to mark it. My memory really isn't what it should be. Okay. Unresolved ambiguity. Do we still have the glimmering somewhere? Are we painting a glimmering here? We are, and it's almost a full. Okay, so we can just combine this with an epics. Okay, that painting done gave us one funds. And what is our staleness? Still a 4. Let's paint with passion. Paint the perfect frost. And yeah, we're still gonna talk to Slakana about the vitality. The curse shrivels! Ah! Oh. That's very nice. Okay, there's the sickness, so as soon as this dream's done, we can get rid of that sickness. Affliction. Wait, does the affliction have remnant aspect? No. Okay. Okay, we got a decrepitude. Right. Each breath we take in this life is weaker than the last, until we come the final breath of all. The process is so slow as to be imperceptible, until one is touched by the creeping breath curse. Okay, so Forge's Redemption requires Grail and Forge, right? So if we really want to do a good job with those, and we require more Forge. So we most definitely will want to do that. Okay, I go here now, then that's a Vagabond's map. Okay, I must have just marked all of my stuff completely wrong. Yeah, we'll dream this affliction away with this vitality. Affliction, vitality. We'll talk to Suakana about... let's talk to her about a glimmering, just to keep it around a little bit longer. Okay, you want the library and painting done. Staleness went down by one. I will paint with this passion now. Paint the perfect rust just to keep it from turning into a dread. Okay. Actually, we could just like take the hanger on in the cult with the perfect frost. And get rid of it that way. The opening stone. The meteorite lies in a shattered temple, ridged like a sea creature, smoothed by its passage through the atmosphere. The old altar must have been crushed centuries ago, but the meteorite responds to our touch. It hums like wires in wind, its surface shifts, and it opens like an eye. I was supposed to take the Grail people in the cult, I just remembered, and turn them into disciples, because we're gonna require just the Grail at Messana. Well, I'll do that next. Because this guy is now a pawn, so Rhaenyra will take you into the cult. Do we have any influences we want to get rid of here? Nope. Hey, there's some more health for us. What has passed? The meteorite is cold and closed and silent. The sands of centuries lies untouched upon it. But here in our hands are the treasures we found within. So the manner in which the alchemist was spread, the focus of amber, another wildering mirror. That's actually a fixed one, that's not even broken. Nice, and Medusa's lament. Right. Okay. Oh, we have a season of suspicion coming. Oh, going on. Right, we wanted to get some money, so let's just sell the Wildering Mirror. At least we can sell at least one without any trouble. We should also just sell all the Iron Spin Trade just to get some money. If, you know, we get too poor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 books. Reading these books would give us some space here, that's for sure. Okay, we can dream about the Peacock's Door. And you want the Glimmering now? Yes. And that painting done, where is our staleness now? It's not in passion, it's in here. Path 3. Okay. We'll use more passion. Paint that glimmering. Okay, Rhaenyra, now a believer. Rhaenyra, we're gonna make you into a disciple. There is the invocation we have done. That will do. Need to try to remember to grab hold of the notoriety every time so that we don't get any evidence right now. And to the Peacock's Door. Okay, so if my things are correct right now, there is a dread waiting for us at the at the Worm Museum. So let's not go to the Worm Museum, let's instead just take that unresolved ambiguity. And dream more about the Peacock's Door. Just put it here, because we're gonna be dreaming about this until, well, the end of times, probably. Or at least until we've actually explored all the Wagabond's maps. Ooh, 20 for that. Nice, which actually, yeah, let's just explore the Wagabond's maps until we get the redoable part, so that we know that we can just use the rest of the Wagabond's maps to turn in to import new anecdotes. And more painting happening, and we're still at 2 right now, so we'll use this one passion to paint. We'll paint a glimmering. Okay, Rhaenyra, now a disciple. And then we'll take Saliba in. It's the invocation of the Ivory Dove. Okay, there's another unresolved ambiguity for us. Do we still have glimmerings with good time in them? Yeah, so we'll combine these two forbidden epics. Okay, Saliba now a believer. Saliba, with the same thing we made you a believer, we're gonna make you into a disciple as well. You're not gonna learn anything new, but you'll think you did. Okay, so we'll head to the Worm Museum now. There is a perfect frost over here. Which sounds about right. Oh! We could have used the perfect frost to get Saliba into cold. And then we'll head back. Okay, what do we find? Maya! So wait, that means we got all the... Yeah, that means we got all the Vagabonds map level stuff done now. So we don't need to do those anymore. Instead, we can just go and do all the other stuff. Right, the Port Dune anecdote stuff. So, let's just head to Messana. We'll send Rhaenyra, and after Saliba's in the cult, we'll send him there as well. A quietly prosperous village rests in the crook of the river, a surprising splash of green against the dusty land behind. The longevity of the villagers surpasses the natural. What are they hiding? Messana, where the villagers routinely remain hale and vigorous past their 100th year. They will resist attempts to pry in their secrets, and they may have curses at their disposal, if we can even penetrate the desert to reach them. Right, off you go! Okay, getting money. Ooh, we get 2 funds for that, so where's our staleness now? It is at 1, so we'll paint once more with just passion, just a perfect frost. Ooh, and you're still there, right, I need to remember to grab a hold of the notoriety every once in a while. Yeah, and we're gonna send, let's just make sure that Grail can deal with this, and Grail can deal with Watchers, okay. Yeah, gonna send Saliba there as soon as he's done being promoted. You want some libraries there right now. Oh, Season of Ambition. Ooh, our graveyard mouth is... Ooh, it's gonna go to 4. Ooh, so that's not good. That most definitely means that once we're done here at Messalina, we're gonna have to go and grab some corpses. Okay. Saliba, go there. You're gonna need some money at some point, but everything else should be fine. Poppy, we'll return this commission to you. And we'll head to the Worm Museum, get a Vagabond's map. Okay. Now I am a lot clearer about life. And then we'll dream this affliction away at this point. Yes, and you're gonna need some more funds there, that's for sure. Okay, painted the painting. Are we complete? Okay, we're not stale at all anymore. Finish that commission there. We don't really care about that anymore. We're probably not gonna do any more commissions at all, because we don't need the spring tree anymore. So let's just paint. And we'll paint the perfect frost. And yeah, we don't need to talk to anyone about anything. You're still gonna require the glimmering, yes. Okay, health back together. 1 funds for that painting, and we're immediately stale. What if we just use, like, if we always put 1 passion, maybe we'll not grow stale as fast. And dream about the peacock's door. Okay, painted that thing. Still stale. Let's paint with all of our passion once more. Just a perfect frost. And here we are at the peacock store. We'll go to the red church right now. Okay, what is that? That's an incarnate essence. That's like Grail 15 or something. Yeah, Grail 15. That's very nice. And we'll head back to the peacock store. Okay, one more unresolved ambiguity for us. So, okay, these, if we combine these, we can still make two port new annexes. Let's make the first one first. Our passions are exhausted, so we can't really do that right now. No. I was thinking that maybe we can just work with it anyways. And what is this? Like a pile of stuff just on that one place. That was interesting. Could do anything with the incarnate essence. Should probably try to see if we can, no, because we need Grail, no, not Grail, Forge to be large for the Forge's redemption to work properly. Let's just hope that we're gonna get some glimmering from the painting, and let's just combine these Vagabonds maps. We could talk to Sulakana about the glimmering to keep it around. Yes, that's actually a better idea. Ooh! Crap! We're gonna be at 5! Oh, damnation! This doesn't look good. Okay, at least there isn't another one coming immediately afterwards. Yeah, we're gonna have to go and find some corpses, that's for sure. Okay, a lot of glimmering there. Right, no more staleness. So if we use, say, one passion and some mystique, are we gonna become stale? Let's paint the perfect frost. And the peak door, yeah, we'll just take this, which is a dread. Of course it is. And we don't have any habits or fascination. No, the season of dread isn't coming. We can use the dread to take these guys in the cult. So that means that we're just gonna go dream about the peacock's door. What do you want? You want the library. Take the library, and then we're gonna need the glimmering at some point. Let's get rid of the dread by taking, let's say, Cat Carol into the cult. And there's our graveyard. 5! 5! It's already at 5! Oh, I don't want to die of that again. Not this time. We already have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 of these things. Where can I get the... Like, there can't be that many more. 1 or 2 at max. Or, I don't know, maybe it's crazy and goes all the way to 13 or something like that. Ah! Where can I find them? Still, I need to find them. What the hell? We can't talk to anyone about anything useful. Okay, we can talk to Sulakana about the imperative of appetite. Ooh, we'll get the curse here. Come on, guys, just... Oh, the curse rivals! The curse rivals! Nice. Okay, maybe we can find a remnant from here. That would be very nice if we found a remnant from here. That would be very nice. Okay. What happened to our stales? We're stale. So, having one passion doesn't prevent us from becoming stale. We're gonna use 2 next time. Okay, we'll head to the Worm Museum. Another perfect frost. So next time there's gonna be a Vagabonds map over there. Wait, we've already found... Raven Isle is a level 14 thing. And we've already found the Wreck of Cristobal and Fort Garruk. So there's only 2 more places there. So we're gonna require a total of 4 Vagabonds maps. And we have the stuff here we need for those. So we don't really need to dream anymore at all. Okay, we'll stop dreaming then. We want to dream bad stuff away. We don't need to dream anything else. That's very nice. So we could give like the frangiclave to someone if we'd really want to summon stuff. But we don't really even want to summon any stuff anymore. Huh. Like, we're clearly getting to the end game, but I just don't know how to finish because I didn't know where to get the last remnants we're gonna need. Okay, what do you want? You want the glimmering now. Yes, 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 yes. Get some glimmering. A long feast. Beneath the granary, we find the deepest secret of Messana, an altar on which are displayed segments of an embalmed human body. Little of it still remains. The visitors must have been feasting on this for years. Is it long flesh? That might account for their longevity. Right? That's gotta be a remnant for us, right? Okay. We don't really need to keep this around for anything because I was just keeping it around because maybe it would be one of the things that would help us with the curse. But the curse didn't touch us, so it doesn't matter. Oh, a fascination. That's unfortunate. Well, we're gonna get a pleading reminiscence from that, so it doesn't really matter. And we're no longer stale, so let's wait until our passions are unexhausted. A long feast. Items of note are displayed on the walls. They might be trophies from unwise travelers, or they might have been possessions of the Long. There is no indication whether the Long was a willing victim or an ancestor or a prisoner, and we'll learn nothing from the villagers now. A Greek inscription on the altar reads, "For the Flood." So we get the sevenfold slaying of the seven coiled. We get the songs of the Carapace Cross. And we get a kingskin Bodran. Hard stuff. And of course the notoriety, but no corpses. Well, that's unfortunate. Okay, next up I think we're gonna head to the Eye of Ikermaui. Which, you know what, let's go to Heap Stanton. It's been around for no. Doesn't sound, neither of these sound like we're gonna find any corpses from here. The Temple of the Seven Coils. It's a temple, maybe we'll find something to eat from there. Okay, so let's go there. Temple of the Seven Coils. Here we require a forge and lantern or moth. And there's a curse here, of course there's a curse here. We'll send the forge people out there. Tristan and lantern people as well. Pope. And funds. A crumbling temple in a shadowed defile. It was built, it seems, in a third history, the one where much later the worms overran Europe, but it exists in all the histories now. The site will tolerate no life, says the journal of Zane Mark Gentis, so we will find no serpents there, but the place sounds cursed, and Gentis recorded a door that his expedition could not open. Right, and then I think we're gonna end this episode here and continue from this point in the next one. I'm Okapa, this has been Cultist Simulator with the Ghoul DLC Second Try. Goodbye world, thanks for watching, see you next time!